Yeah.
That was perfect.
Yeah.
I did, but I've been on for a while.
Honor guard, can put, as is revered.
Another legionnaire has been called to report to the commander of us all. Chaplain?
Let us pray. Eternal God, we bow before you with reverent hearts. Knowing you lead us on in death as you have in life, you have ordered a better home where valor and goodness dwell forever. Mindful of noble service, you have called you to everlasting rest and eternal peace. For those who mourn, touch their hearts with healing and keep bright the memory of Neil. Knowing, dear Lord, you live in all places at all times, and you teach us the meaning of goodness, an unfailing hope. Heal our broken hearts and bind our wounds. Comfort your people. In our sorrow, give thanks for your gift of eternal life. Your love and welcoming arms as you receive our souls. Until for us also the day breaks and we step into eternity, grant us to live so our souls honor the veteran who precedes us in order to light the wayward fire. Amen.
We come to honor the memory of one who offered life and service for God and country, one who is now enrolled in that great spirit army whose footfalls cause no sound. Proudly, we remember their service in time of war. Because of them, our lives are free. Because of them, our nation lives. Because of them, our lives are free. May the ceremonies of today deepen our reverence for our honored comrade and friend. Legionnaires and friends, we realize how futile are mere words. Excuse me. Legionnaires, we realize how futile are mere words to express our deep and abiding sympathy in your loss. May you feel our comrade is at rest and in endless peace. Surely there is an afterlife for all who have been loyal and true, a life where love and hope and fulfillment that escape us here shall be given to us to be ours forever. The chaplain.
O God, who heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds, look in tender pity and compassion upon thy servants, whose joy has been turned into mourning. Leave them not comfortless, but grant that they may be drawn closer to thee and to one another by their common sorrow. Fill their souls with the light and comfort of thy presence. Grant unto them such a vision that life, wherein all mysteries shall be revealed, and all tears be wiped away, that they may be able to endure. So dwell with them and be their God until the day break and the shadows flee away. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Arnegard, post. Officer of the day, carry out your duty.
Sir.
Thank you.
Ma'am, on behalf of the President of the United States Navy, and a grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation of your loved one's faithful and honorable service. This concludes our military rights. We'd like to thank the Carl Fock family for the opportunity to provide these rights for our fallen heroes. And salute to left face. Forward march.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Scott. I'm the pastor at Fifth Reformed Church. It's my honor and privilege to be here today to celebrate the life and the faith of Neil Carl and to remind all of us that our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Grace to you and peace from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ through the indwelling of his Holy Spirit. Please join me in the spirit of prayer. Let's pray together. Lord God, you are holy and righteous and true, and we confess today that all too often we are none of those things. We confess that we are not the people you created us to be or called us to be. We have not loved you with our whole heart or our neighbors as ourselves. Forgive our sin, O God, and create in us a new and willing spirit, so that in our living we may serve you, and in our dying we may enter the joy of your presence through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear these words of assurance. With everlasting love, I will have compassion on you, says the Lord your Redeemer. I am the one who blots out your transgressions for my own sake, and I will not remember your sins. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. Amen. will now receive a ministry of music, How Great Thou Art. Friends and family, we're here to do three things today. To be comforted by God's word in the midst of the loss of one of the Lord's own. To give thanks for his life. And to hear the gospel of Jesus Christ proclaimed anew. So we begin with Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. The Heidelberg Catechism reminds us that our only comfort in life and in death is that we belong, body and soul, in life and in death to our faithful Savior, Jesus Christ. Neil Carl has died, and he has departed this world. But that's not the most important truth about him for us to recognize today. The most important truth is that he belongs to the Lord. And the Lord is watching over his life, protecting and providing and leading for him while he was here, and now protecting and providing and leading him now that he has departed. The psalmist is very clear on this. The Lord watches over both our coming into this world and our leaving of this world. So I invite you to be comforted today. While it's hard to receive this news that Neil has died, he is with the Lord. And for him, it's all goodness and blessing and glory and even relief. It's relief. And knowing that he's with the Lord allows us to be able to move into a season of giving thanks. Giving thanks for the blessing that Neil was to so many, and giving thanks for the blessings that he received in this life. The Bible calls us to give thanks in every season of life. And so it falls to us to give thanks today, to give thanks for Neil, to give thanks that he was the best kind of husband, father, and grandfather a man could be. Neil truly was a family man who loved to bless his family with trips and with camping and going on school field trips and just spending time with the family. We can give thanks that Neil had a servant's heart, always willing to help others in need, helping his wife with some of her health struggles, helping as a volunteer with the food truck at Fifth Reformed Church on a regular basis. We can give thanks that Neil was a gentle-spirited man. And in fact, one of the verses that he wanted read here today was from James 1, verse 19. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. This was Neil. And we can give thanks for all the fruits of the Spirit that were present in him. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. These are the very character traits of Jesus. And so we can give thanks for the way that the life of Christ flowed through Neil's life. We can give thanks that he loved his country. Already we've acknowledged that today with military rights. But he also served as a career postal worker. Again, serving our country and our community. We can give thanks that Neil found joy in getting his hands dirty in the garden and in the acres of blueberries. We can give thanks that Neil found joy in restoring old cars and taking people for rides in those cars. We can give thanks that he loved the Lord and he loved his church. Neil served as a deacon. Neil served as a Sunday school teacher. And Neil served as a cadet leader, not just for weeks or months or years, but he served in a way that could be measured in decades. How many people can mark their service in a particular role by serving for decades? We can give thanks that Neil was a man who loved the Word of God, faithfully reading the scriptures and underlining and spending time daily in his Bible. We can give thanks that Neil was a man of faith. In fact, one of the verses that he wanted read here today was Hebrews 11, where it says this, "Now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance of what we do not see." We can give thanks that Neil had this kind of faith, an assurance that though he'd never seen heaven, that's where he was headed when his assignment here on planet Earth was done. We can give thanks that Neil was a man who believed in Jesus. He confessed sin, he trusted in Jesus for his forgiveness, and it's that trust in Jesus that makes this day a very different kind of day for us. I'm reminded of how Jesus related to the reality of death on the occasion of Lazarus getting sick and eventually dying. You might remember that story. His sisters sent word to Jesus, "Please come, Lazarus is sick," and Jesus purposefully stays away until Lazarus dies, until Lazarus has been in the tomb now 4 days. And finally, Jesus comes to Bethany, and Martha meets him on the way into town, almost with an accusing tone, as if to say, "If you had been here, this would not have happened." And Jesus responds, knowing that the story wasn't over. He says, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even though he dies." Jesus did not say, I know a few things about the resurrection, and I have some pointers for how to live. No, what Jesus did say is, I am the resurrection. I am the life. Believe in me, and you will live, even when you die. Friends, this is the good news for us today. For Neil and for all who believe in Jesus, we can live with the hope of heaven when we die. Today is a day of hope for us, not because Neil was a good man. Neil was a good man, but that's not the reason we have hope. What gives us hope is this: Jesus, the one who died and rose from the grave, makes it possible for us to die and to look forward with life beyond the grave with our Father in heaven. The life of the risen Christ becomes the life within us by faith. When we trust, when we believe, when we surrender our own efforts at trying to lead a good enough life and simply trust in Jesus, the one who is the resurrection and the life, then his life becomes the life within us, and it changes everything. The most well-known verse of Scripture makes this explicitly clear. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that whoever believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life. Friends, if you were blessed by Neil in his living, I invite you to be blessed by him now in his dying. The hope that we have for Neil's eternity, a hope found in Christ alone, that same hope is something that we are all invited to receive. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible says, and you will be saved. Thank God, Neil is safe with his Father in heaven. Amen. We'll now receive a ministry of music, Living for Jesus.
I'm Paul Burmeister, the former pastor at Fifth Reformed Church, Scott's predecessor. So I got to know Neil for about 6 years, just short of 6 years that we were there together, and got to marry the two of you in 2014, June 21st, something like that. It is my great privilege to be here today. Neil wanted me to do this. and I wouldn't have it any other way. So we already had the military rites, which was great. Nowadays, they're very busy people, and when we can accommodate their schedule and do it at the beginning of the service so they can get on their way to another one, it helps them. So thank you for your concession about that. Neil wore a lot of uniforms. He wore his Navy uniform, of which he was so proud, and he had a lot of gold, a lot of bling. And then he wore a postal uniform, I'm guessing. He wore a cadet uniform. I'm guessing he had a blueberry uniform, but I don't know that for sure. So he was a very uniform guy, but he loved to serve. He was a servant-hearted man. But he proudly served in the Navy for 20 years. It's the only way you can retire from the Navy is you make 20. And he made it to Senior Chief Petty Officer. That's no small accomplishment. His career included tours in California, Hawaii, sounds pretty good so far, Tennessee, Japan, and Whidbey Island, Washington, which is a pretty sweet place as well. But most notably, he did two tours in Vietnam. That was not a walk in the park. He served with distinction aboard the lovely old aircraft carrier, the USS Saratoga, which has now been decommissioned. His personal decorations and awards, this kind of stuff that we like to put on our chest, include the National Defense Service Medal, the Navy Good Conduct Medal with 3 bronze stars. Each of those stars represents a 5-year span of time. So he had 4 of them, if you count the original one, plus 3 stars, 20 years. That means he was good all 20 of those years. Never messed around. The Vietnam Service Medal with 3 bronze stars. The Republic of Vietnam Campaign Medal with silver ribbon, silver device. And the Armed Forces Expeditionary Service Medal. So he was a decorated veteran. He was proud to be part of the aviation electronics community, the systems maintenance people who keep planes and helicopters in the air, who keep them flying well, everything functioning, and who keep the crew safe because of that. So that was something he was very proud of. He rose quickly through the ranks for him to become an E-8, a senior chief in the Navy in 20 years, is remarkable. It's typically about a 27 or 28 year hitch to get to that level. So that tells you something about the kind of hard work and devotion to duty that Neil had. Chiefs are the backbone of Navy leadership. It is an enormous challenge and an honor and an accomplishment to become a chief petty officer in the United States Navy. That was true back in the 60s and 70s, and it's still true now. The chief was a leader of leaders, a teacher, a trainer, a manager, a developer, the supreme example of conduct and character to all the troops. Even commissioned officers looked to their chief for wisdom, for guidance, for understanding about the morale and the condition of the troops, and for so many things. They possessed wisdom and insight because of their experience. Senior Chief Neil Carl was one of the best, and I'm proud to say that Neil was my shipmate. He liked to call me Chaps, short for chaplain. He didn't usually call me Pastor Paul, it was usually chaplain. And that meant a lot to me. I liked that. He always used it as a term of endearment. The core values of the Navy are honor and courage and commitment, and Neil displayed those better than most. Because he lived his life, like the song we just heard, Living for Jesus, he lived it with a sense of honor and courage and commitment to Christ in the midst of a community that always isn't that receptive to things spiritual, things religious. It can be a pretty ungodly community at times. I was in it for 27 years. I can tell you a thing or two. But for Neil, it was his commitment to his Lord and Savior that was the bedrock of his duty and his ability to be such a strong leader. I have no doubt that God used him in his two decades of service to our nation to not only share his great knowledge and skill of aviation, electronics, and all the technology stuff that they learned, but to also share his knowledge of Christ, to model a life of godliness, and to demonstrate honor and courage and commitment to the supreme calling, the supreme life purpose of any person, to live for God and not merely for oneself. As I said, when I think of Neil, I think of a servant. He was a truly servant-hearted man. And as a family, you know that better than anyone. Jesus once said, "I am among you as one who serves, and the greatest among you should be the servant of all." And we can take great comfort that probably this very moment, Neil is doing what he loved to do best. He's serving in the courts of heaven. Whatever that looks like, he's serving there as well, because that was his heart. Thanks be to God. At this time, let me offer a prayer, and then we'll go to the words of committal. Please pray with me. Lord Jesus Christ, we come to you in earnest and in humble prayer. We acknowledge that you, as you said, are the way and the truth and the life, and that no one comes to God the Father except through you. And your promise to us is that everyone who calls upon your name will be saved. We thank you for that marvelous truth today. We thank you that Neil did that. I pray that every person here this afternoon would be drawn by your Holy Spirit to call upon you in faith. Lord, we thank you today for Neil. What a gift his life was to us. Thank you for giving him to this family, to all of us, to know and to love in our time on this earth. Father, thank you for the grace that you gave to Neil over all the years of his life. Thank you for giving him the strength and the desire to serve you, to serve our nation, to serve your church, and to glorify your name through all of his gifts and his abilities and his labors. Lord, we thank you today that for Neil, all the pain and the suffering of this mortal life are ended, and he is now beholding your glory and singing your praises in your heaven. God, we thank you for making Neil the wonderful person that he was, and for everything in him that was so special. And there's so many things that we could talk about today. Lord, I thank you too for this family, and I pray for them now, especially for Sharon, for Carlina and Ben, for Christopher and Julie, for the 16 grandchildren, for every one of this family, that you would be near to them in the days to come, and that you would grant them your divine peace. And we pray too for dear friends and for neighbors, fellow church members, for all who deeply grieve Neil's parting from their life. And now, Father, we bless you and we praise you for your goodness, and especially for the matchless gift of salvation. Father, we pray that as we depart, you will bless the fellowship that is shared in the moments ahead and in the days to come, that our happy memories of Neil and our common love for him will bind our hearts together. We ask you to watch over us and to protect us in our journeys home, and may your blessing rest upon us as we part. Grant your strength and peace in our lives, for we pray it in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We'll be doing the committal here, since we're not headed to the graveside. It's not very nice out there today, though. Hear first of all these words from the book of Revelation, almost the very end of Scripture, Revelation 21, 1-5. "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them, and he will be their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. Then he who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new. And he said, write this down, because these words are trustworthy and they are true. The Bible says that it is from the dust that we are made, and it is to the dust that we return. St. Paul reminds us that none of us lives to himself and none of us dies to himself. If we live, we live unto the Lord, and if we die, we die unto the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. And as Scott said, quoting Jesus from John chapter 11, Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he may die, yet shall he live. Whoever lives and believes in me will never die. So therefore now, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life that is ours through Jesus Christ our Lord, we commit Neil Carl into the hands of Almighty God, and we commit his remains to their temporary resting place. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away, but blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Let's pray as we close. O God, our Creator and our Redeemer and our Friend, even as you fashioned us out of the ground at creation and breathed your life into us, so also we know that you have promised to raise us from the dust of death at the coming of your Son. Father, we thank you again for Neil and for all the ways that he enriched our life. We thank you that for him death is now past, and he has entered into the joy and the glory that you have prepared for him. Father, again, we pray that you will uphold and comfort every member of this family and grant them an abiding sense of your presence. May you receive honor and glory and praise in this day and through all our lives, for we ask it in Christ's name. Amen. Receive the blessing of God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord had make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. That concludes the service for today. The Lord be with you.
On behalf of the family, I know you are all family. Thank you so much for being here today. Thank you to Pastor Scott and Pastor Paul and the military for their presence here today as well, too. We aren't going to do a formal dismissal here this morning because it's just us here, so please take your time, and thanks again for coming.